Hi, everybody, and welcome to Popdust Presents. Today we have Lauren Aquilina with us.
Nailed it. The pronunciation.
I had to practice before we started a little bit.
Thanks for having me.
Yeah, absolutely. You're joining us while you're on tour right now, right?
Yeah.
And you just released a brand new song called Tobacco in My Sheets.
Yes, on Friday, which was really nerve-wracking, but I'm glad it's out.
Tell us a bit about that song.
It took like 6 months to write in total because it's just like super personal, and I knew that every lyric had to be like perfect, but it's written as a letter to my mom.
Yeah.
About my relationship with drugs and alcohol after my first heartbreak and when I started like experimenting a bit more, and
yeah,
kind of talking to my mom about, you know, I'm sorry if I'm a massive disappointment, but I know that you probably went through the same things after your first heartbreak, and it kind of like ties it all together that way.
Yeah, that's a very like deeply personal song.
Very personal.
What is the songwriting process like for you? You said that one was up 6 months of...
Yeah, it doesn't usually take me that long.
Okay.
Because I've got into a real habit of, I mean, for the past 3 years, I've mostly been focusing on writing for other artists.
Okay.
Which is a very, like, one day vibe. So you just go in and you, like, get a song done in one day and then you're done with it.
Yeah.
But this was the first song, I guess, that I, like, when I knew I was writing for me again and I really wanted to take my time over it. And I had the first verse and chorus, which I wrote on my own, for ages, and I just couldn't work out like how to frame it in the right way. And then like a few months later, I took it to my writing partner, this guy called Johnny Hawkins in the UK, who I write with all the time. And I played it to him, and I just didn't know if it was any good or not.
Yeah.
But I played it to him, and he was like, "This is amazing. Like, we have to finish it." And then we finished it together.
Do you begin with the music or with the lyrics? Are you playing piano, or how do you?
That one started with the lyric. Like, I literally woke up and there was tobacco all over my bed. And I started kind of singing to myself as a joke. I was like, there's tobacco in my sheets, my mother won't be proud. And then I was like, okay, maybe this is like an actual song. And I sat down at the piano and started trying to work out chords for it.
Yeah.
But that happens to me a lot actually, when it kind of just starts as a joke.
Yeah.
And then I'm like, oh, maybe this is a real song.
That's really cool actually. And so how's like the fan reception been for it?
A lot of people have been telling me it's like their favorite thing that I've ever done.
Yeah.
Which makes me so happy because I have this huge complex that I peaked as a songwriter at 16.
I saw you said that on Twitter.
Yeah, people always like, there was these four songs that I released when I was 16, 17. And people, my fan base seemed to really love those songs, which is so amazing, and I'm so grateful for that.
Yeah.
And you know, but people always tell me after shows, like, one of those songs is their favorites, and I was like, oh my god, am I ever gonna, you know, like, beat these songs? But a lot of people have been saying that this one beats them for them, which is, I'm personally very happy about.
That's great. I don't know, do you feel like maybe those earlier songs, maybe you just didn't have as much pressure on yourself or something, or?
Yeah, I think, like, has a lot to do with that. Like, I wrote those songs completely alone in my bedroom, and I think you can hear that in the songwriting. It just feels really natural, and I think then I got kind of pushed and pulled in a few different directions musically, and you know, every artist has to experiment, but because I started so young, everybody kind of watched me do that, so I couldn't do that behind closed doors. And it took me a while to kind of come back to the songwriting that made me started, but that's what this new song is.
Are there certain types of music or maybe like artists that you tend to gravitate towards stylistically?
Yeah, I mean, it's like, it's constantly changing because I'm always listening to new music, but Alanis Morissette has always been a huge inspiration, especially lyrically, just like how, you know, honest and brave a lot of the lyrics are. And that's something that I've like really tried to embody in the new music. But then, I mean, for this new song, Sarah Bareilles was definitely like an influence musically. I've always loved her kind of style of piano ballads and letting it be all about the lyric and less about like a catchy melody, but just a melody that works for the lyric. But I love pop music. I'm just always listening to new pop music and getting inspired by everything that I can. So
that's really cool. And right now you're on tour with Sasha Sloan, I believe. That's
yes.
Correct. And you said you're heading to Atlanta soon. That's pretty cool.
Yeah, we go to Atlanta tomorrow, and we've got like 4 dates of the tour. left. I'm going to be really sad when it ends.
How much distance did you travel, or how long have you been doing?
We're 2 weeks in and we've got 1 week left. So it's like, I think it's like 13 or 14 shows in total that we've done. We've covered, like, we did all down the West Coast. So we're doing like East Coast right now, and then we're doing like Nashville and Texas.
You had been on tour before with Taylor Swift, no?
I did one show with Taylor in London. Yeah.
Okay, in London. I was going to say, because I would have imagined that you would have been like, you would have covered some ground.
Yeah, that would have been insane if I'd have done like a world tour with Taylor Swift. She tweeted me like so casually, like a few years ago, saying that she really liked my first EP. And then I got an email a few days later from this promoter saying, Taylor wants you to be one of the openers for the London date on the 1989 tour. And I was obviously like, yes. So
that's so cool.
Yeah, it was so
crazy. Did you answer her tweet, or you just like were like, oh?
And then imagine if I just ghosted her. Yeah. I was like, no, I'm done now.
Like, you wouldn't answer her, so then she got a promoter to email you.
No, I think I just retweeted it, and like I quote tweeted it and just put like a ton of exclamation marks or something.
And how did she manage to come across the music?
I still don't know. I think my first EP came out the same day as her album Red.
Okay.
And
so you were competition.
The thing
she
is,
had to
like,
study the competition.
My first EP did like really unexpectedly well, and it was actually in the UK iTunes top 10.
Wow.
At the time, which is, I don't know how that happened, but it did. So maybe she saw it there or something and like checked it out. I don't know. I know she's like really good at discovering new music as well. So
how much time did you have to prepare for that show? Was it like the next day?
No, we had like a few months. It was
okay.
Good. And I did like a week of rehearsals. I rehearsed on my birthday. That's how dedicated I was to it. And then I got to like hang out with her after the show, and like she was
really cool.
She was so nice.
You're based in London now, right?
Yeah.
And is that where you're doing a lot of these songwriting sessions?
Yeah, I kind of split my time between London and LA.
Okay.
Because there's so much good pop music being made in LA, and it feels like that's like the place to be. Whereas London's good for more of an authentic kind of songwriting vibe, but then when I want to do like really pop stuff, that's when I go to LA. And there's some amazing producers and writers there. So
do you like writing for other people? Do you prefer it? Compared to writing for yourself?
I've had the best time writing for other people. Like, I think it's made me a better writer. I think it's made me a better singer. And it just kind of allows me to put a different hat on every day and be completely creatively free, which is something that I didn't really know how to do before.
Yeah.
It's taught me to collaborate. It's taught me so many things. So now that I'm writing for me again, there's no way I want to stop writing for other people, because I think that would only like, I don't know, it would like inhibit me in some way.
Yeah.
So I'm going to keep doing both and kind of do 50-50, I think.
That's really cool.
Yeah.
How did you, was it like after, you know, success of some of your early music, people were just started asking you to write for them, or?
No, it was like,
you put an ad on Craigslist?
When I stopped being an artist, like the first time, I was so done with music. I was literally like, I never want to do this again. Like, I was so depressed. I'm really unhappy. And I don't know, I think just like the industry side of it really got to me. And I was actually trying to become a flight attendant at the time. And then I left my label, I left my management company. I like, you know, in a friendly way, I'd kind of cut ties with everybody. And then a few weeks after, like during the process of me applying to become a flight attendant, I got an email from the guy who's now my manager, and he basically wouldn't stop emailing me until I agreed to take a meeting with him, and he convinced me that I should try being a songwriter. And I was like, okay, cool. And I just started from the bottom, and I just like, because I think at the time in the UK I had a little bit of a reputation as like an artist who tried but maybe, you know, didn't do as well as everybody thought, and it was hard to like change my branding into like a songwriter that people trusted. So I really had to like start at the bottom and do some like pretty bad sessions at the beginning. It's nice because I get to work with artists now who are like 5 or 6 years younger than me, and will say to me in the session, like, oh, I listened to your music when I was in high school. And
wow.
And it's really cool.
That is really cool. But are you ever on a flight and you're just like looking at the attendants like, could have been me.
Damn.
Could have been me. Yeah. This pesky
literally all
music
the time.
Industry.
All the time. All
right. Well, Lauren, thank you so much for spending time here.
Thank you.
Thank you for
having
coming me. On Popdust. Have a great rest of your tour.
Thank you
we'll
so
be,
much.
We'll be excited to hear the new music when it comes out.
Thank you so much.